Good evening, everyone. I'm Anna. The busy day is finally over. Welcome, everyone, to our new series, Learn Chinese While Sleeping. In this series, I will tell you about the history of Chinese and the introduction of some famous tourist places, because I want you to submerge yourselves into a new portal of knowledge, even while you are asleep. May this series make you all dream about China and its amazing stories. You can tell me what things you are interested in, or do you like this style of learning? You can leave a message to let me know. Now, close your eyes, relax, fasten your seatbelts, and get ready for a whole new learning adventure. You are about to step in when you sleep. Let's listen to Bedtime Stories. 第一章 Chapter 1 中华文明有数千年历史，是世界上最为古老辉煌的文明之一。 Chinese civilization is one of the oldest and most splendid cultures in the world, which dates back to thousands of years ago.
与世界上许多古老文明相似，中国早期文明与神话传说难以分割。
Similar to many old civilizations, its early culture is integrated with legends and myths.
神话传说中，中华文明起源于盘古开天辟地，女娲造人。
As described in mythology, Chinese civilization begins with Pángǔ, the creator of the universe, and 女娲, the creator of mankind.
让我们先来说一说盘古开天辟地。
Let's talk about Pangu's story first.
盘古开天辟地，很早很早以前，天和地还没有分开，宇宙只是混沌一片。
According to legend, in the beginning of the world, the sky and earth were not separated, and there was only darkness and chaos.
人类的老祖宗盘古是一个巨人，就生长在这混沌之中，一直经过了十万八千年。
Our ancestor Pángǔ, a giant, had been born and growing up in it for 108,000 years.
有一天，盘古忽然醒了过来，睁开眼睛，一看模糊一片，什么都看不见。 One day, he suddenly woke up. Opening the eyes, he found that everything was blurred and invisible. 他非常生气，抓过一把斧子，朝眼前用力一挥。Angrily, he grabbed an axe and wielded it with an effort. 只听一声巨响，混沌一片的东西忽然分开了。With a bang, the cubes were split all of a sudden. 一些轻而轻的东西缓缓上升，变成了天。重而浊的东西慢慢下降，变成了地。The light and clear air rose up to the sky, and the heavy and turbid to the earth. 天地分开以后，盘古怕他们还要合在一起，就头顶天，脚踩地，随着他们的变化而变化。After it, Pángǔ propped up the sky with his head and stepped on the ground with his feet, fearing that they might close. 这样不知过了多少年，天和地逐渐成形了。盘古也累得倒了下去。Thousands of years passed. The heaven and the earth finally separated. But Pángǔ fell down exhaustedly. 盘古死后，他呼出的气息变成了风和云，发出的声音变成了雷。Following his death, his breath turned into the wind and clouds, and the sound he made became thunder. 双眼变成了太阳和月亮，手足和身躯变成了大地的四极和高山。The eyes became the sun and the moon, and his four limbs and body became the four quadrants and mountains of the globe. 血液变成江河，筋骨变成道路，肌肉变成田地。His blood the rivers,and his muscles and bones, the layers of the earth.
毛发变成星星和花草树木，就连身上的汗也变成了雨露和甘霖。
His flesh became the soil, his hair and fur the stars, flowers and trees.Even his sweat turned to rain and dew.
人类的老祖宗盘古用他整个的身体创造了这美丽而丰富的宇宙。
盘古 created the rich and beautiful world with his body.
女娲补天造人。
女娲 repairs the sky and creates man.
盘古开天辟地后，世上本没有人， 是女娲按照自己的样子，用黄泥塑造出了人类。
It is that there was no man when the sky and the earth were separated by Pángǔ. It was 女娲 who made human beings after her own model with yellow clay.
此后人们便开始在大地上幸福地生活着。
From then on, men began to live in peace and happiness on the earth.
天有不测风云，一年忽然天崩地裂，大火肆虐。洪水滔天，野兽横行伤人。
Unexpectedly, one year, the four pillars supporting the heaven suddenly collapsed, and the earth cracked. A great fire raged. Torrential water flooded. All the lands, fierce animals, preyed on men.
女娲把五彩石融化，再用这些融化了的液体把天上的洞补好。
Then NÜwa melted five colored stones, using them to mend the cracks in the sky.
然后他又将一只万年巨龟的四足斩下，把它们用作天柱，支撑住了天地的四方。
To replace the broken pillars, she cut off the four legs of a huge turtle and used them to support the fallen sky.
就这样，天补好了，四个角撑住了，洪水被驯服，猛兽被消灭，人类的生活又恢复到往日的幸福祥和之中。
The sky was patched up. Its four corners were lifted.The flood was tamed. Harmful animals were killed. And the innocent people were able to restore their happy lives.
San, Huang.
五帝 Three sovereign and five emperors.
在早期父系氏族社会中，出现了一些杰出的部落联盟领袖，其中最著名是三皇五帝。
In the early patrilineal clan society, some outstanding tribal alliance leaders appeared, among which the most famous were the three sovereigns and five emperors.
虽然当时国家还没有出现，他们并非帝王，但在中国文化传统中，他们被视为圣贤明君。
although the country had not come into being at that time. These rulers were regarded as semi-mythical sage kings and moral exemplars.
其中的皇帝被视为中华民族的祖先。
Tradition considers one of them, Huang Di, as an ancestor of the Chinese people.
中国人自称是炎黄子孙的由来。
The reason of the Chinese claiming to be descendants of Yan and Huang.
Yan Huang Zi Sun.
The descendants of Yan and Huang.
在三皇五帝中最具有代表性的部落联盟领袖是神农和皇帝。
神农 and 皇帝 were the representatives of the three sovereign and five emperors.
神农又称炎帝，他是农业生产和医药的发明者。
神农 also caught with the invention of farming and medication.
用木制作来耒耜，教人民耕种。
He invented the wooden plow and taught people the art of agriculture.
又曾尝百草，发现药材，教人治病。
By experimenting with various plants, he discovered medicinal herbs and taught people how to treat disease.
皇帝又称轩辕氏。
皇帝 also called 轩辕。
他不但在军事上足智多谋，而且还是个伟大的发明家。
He is resourceful in invention as well as in war, and is credited with the invention of many things.
人们认为车、船、衣服、房子、文字、养蚕织布等都是他发明的。
Like carts and boats, clothes, houses, writing, and silkworm breeding and silk weaving.
各部落联盟之间的战争催化了部落之间的融合。
Was urged the mixture and the assimilation of different tribes.
最终形成了中原地区炎帝、黄帝两大部落联盟的统一。
And eventually formed a tribal alliance of Huang Di and Yan Di.
Huang Di 成为最高
Ling Xiu. Huang Di became the chief. 这就是现在中国人自称是炎黄子孙的由来。That is why the Chinese call themselves the descendants of Yan and Huang.
大禹治水。
禹, the great and the flood.
禹是治水安民的历史英雄人物。
禹 is the hero of controlling flood.
尧舜时期，洪水泛滥为害。
It is said that in the reign of Yao and Shun, the overrunning flood was mischievous.
Shun 命禹治水，居外十三年，过家门不入。
Shun recruited Yu to controlling flood.Spending a back-breaking 13 years and bypassing his house 3 times but never go in.
用疏导法治水，导小水入鱼川，导川水至于海。
Yu dredged new river channels as outlets, guiding water to river and river to sea.
不仅消除了洪水，还为农业生产发展创造了良好的条件。
This not only eliminated the flood, but contributed to the development of agriculture.
禹因有大功于人民，被尊称为大禹，并因此被舜选为接班人。
Yu was revered as 大禹, the great for his achievement, and selected to succeed to the throne by Shun.
以上就是我们今天所有的睡前故事了。
The above is all our bedtime stories today.
在这段视频中
In this video,
我们谈到了关于创造世界和人类的中华神话以及早期的中华文明。
We talked about the Chinese myths.Of the creation of the world and mankind as well as the early Chinese civilization.
你们喜欢这部影片吗?
Do you like this video?
这只是我们这个系列的一个篇章而已。
Well, that's just a glimpse of the stories we are yet to tell.
下期视频，我们会继续为大家带来一些有关于中国的景点介绍和文化。
In the next video, We will continue to bring you more about introduction of famous attractions in China and culture.
如果平时你的工作十分忙碌，
If you are usually very busy at work or having a hard day,
那我们希望大家能继续关注在睡眠中学习中文这个系列。
Then we hope you will continue to pay attention to the series of Learn Chinese While You Sleep.
我们会在您睡觉休息时和你一起慢慢学习各种有趣的中国故事、文化和有名的景点。
Together, we will slowly learn all kinds of interesting Chinese stories, culture, and famous attractions while you sleep and rest.
祝大家在安稳的睡眠中慢慢的吸收中国知识，我们下次再见吧。
May you all have peaceful minds as you all dive into your sleep, carrying the knowledge you all learned in this video. See you next time.
好梦 ，Good dream. Thank you.